Hello, this is the Jurassic Expert back with yet another video. And you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, what's this? These do not look like Jurassic World things. And yeah, originally when I was making the channel, I was wanting to make it mainly Jurassic World stuff. But recently I saw the new How to Train Your Dragon movie and I really liked it. And none of you probably know, but when I was younger, it was kind of the perfect time when How to Train Your Dragon came out, so I was kind of instantly hooked on that franchise. So yeah, and so when I saw the latest film, I just kind of realized, wait, this is the last time these things aren't going to ever be in stores, probably. So then I decided, for old time's sake, I'll get a couple of them. And as I was looking at them, I thought, you know what? What the heck? I'll just make a video as well. So yeah, here are a couple of the How to Train Your Dragon things I've gotten so far. First of all, we'll go into the human characters. So first of all, we get Grimmel, the main villain in the new film. Articulation wise, his arm can go back that much. And yeah, articulation is not as impressive as the Jurassic World figures. One thing I will critique is the way how he's holding the crossbow. It looks kind of strange, because the way out that he should be holding it would be if there was a little trigger or something at the bottom. So I'm quite surprised that they did not do that, and instead they did this. But yeah, nonetheless, I think it is a pretty cool figure, and there is articulation in the head as well. So it could go a little bit side to side. There's a little bit of a head pivot because it is on a ball joint, but it's hindered by this piece here. So yeah, now let's go into the main hero, one of the main heroes in the film, Hiccup. Again, if you don't know much about How to Train Your Dragon, I do highly suggest looking at the other films. But yeah, I just really love the films, and I figured, you know what, might as well do a review for a couple of the new How to Train Your Dragon figures. So yeah. So here's Hiccup, in his fireproof kind of armor that you see in the film, along with his fire sword, which we will take a look at first. I do like the fire effect on it. I think it looks really nice for a small little sword. Articulation wise, you could move Hiccup's arms in a full 360. Legs can also move in a full 360. Head cannot move in a full 360, it can move side to side about that much. There is head pivot, because it is on a ball joint, you can look down that much, and up that much. So yeah. Now let's actually get into the dragons. Okay, we're just going to leave Hiccup off to the side there. So first of all, let's take a look at the action feature with the Death Gripper. So you got this little spine here, press the button, and it's a spring-loaded bolt green projectile. And yeah, one thing that did kind of bum me out was the fact that the tail wasn't like bendy wire. That would have been really cool to have. But I'd say it looks very similar to its film counterpart. I do really like this kind of airbrushing effect they got going on along with the sculpt. Yeah. And the company that made this is Spinmaster. So in case some of you are like, wait, this wasn't made by Mattel, right? No, it's made by Spinmaster. Yeah. And the figure feels quite sturdy here, except for maybe the teeth and the tip of the tail, making sense because it is quite thin plastic, but otherwise it feels really sturdy. So yeah, there's the Death Gripper. Just gonna move Krimel off to the side there. And I actually got like a little gift set, is what they called it at Target, which came with Hiccup, Toothless, and the Light Fury. So let's take a look at this little special thing. So it's a little kind of black light in this crystal, which I do think is quite clever. But then again, you could see like all the animatronics going on inside of it, so it kind of ruins the illusion a little bit. So pretty much, you press the little button. I don't know how well you could see that on camera, but pretty much it creates this pattern on the wing. So yeah, that is really cool. And we'll go in with that feature with Toothless as well, so you could see this pattern. So the Light Fury I do really like. It looks quite similar to the film counterpart. One thing I would say is, again, I wish that this was bendy wired or had a swivel or something, just because it feels like it could bend if the bendy wire was inside of it. And there is, let's go over articulation actually. So there's not very much articulation. It's pretty much in the front arms, that's it. Both arms could go not that much, and then that much, and that's all there is to articulation. The mouth, I would say, looks pretty good. One thing I would critique is this little seam here, for the little, I don't even know what those would be. So yeah, so you squeeze these two legs together, and it pretty much makes a little flapping motion. So yeah, and the eyes are nicely painted. I forgot to go over that with this. Yeah. So I'm going to try finishing up this review quickly. So Toothless, also you press the back legs, pull the back legs back, and it fires a blue projectile. I gotta say, this figure does look really cool until you look at the mouth. It looks really derpy with its mouth. And also the mouth isn't really painted on the inside. But yeah, I'd say this is a really cool figure. The wings do work for articulation. I also forgot to mention that with the Death Gripper. And yeah, articulation for the figure, not that much. So yeah. Maybe you'll actually be able to... No, if anything, it's making it hard to see. But you could kind of see through the glossy drawings, you probably can see what the pattern would look like. So yeah, let's get all these kind of lined up. So for a comparison with something that I would usually review, here they all are next to the Battle Damage Attack Pack blue figure. And for a human comparison from the Jurassic World line, here we have Lockwood Bal Owen. And here, Zoan next to the crystal. And there's a size comparison for the blue next to the crystal. And just moving these out of the way. So for the comparison with the two human characters you get, okay, Hiccup does not want to stand right now. So, here they are, next to Owen. They're about the same size as you saw for a brief moment. There you go. There we go. So there's your human comparison. And for comparison with Attack Pack version of the Jurassic World figure there is blue. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, I'm probably not going to do too many of these. I don't even know if this is going to be the only How to Train Your Dragon video. I really hope you did enjoy this though. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention is that the projectiles are the same. You could swap them out, they both work the same. So, yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. And found these figures interesting. So yeah, I know this is not something that I usually do, but I figured, you know what, I might as well, because I just have a lot of nostalgia for the How to Train Your Dragon series, and this is the last film installment, so I figured, you know what, I watched it a couple of weeks ago, and I thought, I need to make a video. As soon as I do a couple of Jurassic World videos I needed to make before, but yeah. So, as always, remember to like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. And hit the notification bell to get notified whenever I put up new videos. And, as always, dinosaurs might be older than you, but you are never too old for dinosaurs. Bye-bye.